I can see why he said that. You do seem angry.
Of course I'm angry now. In large part due to his absurd overreaction to what is simply passion for my work. Supercilious fool. He's passionate about things too, as I intend to remind him by relieving him of his prized possession. A venomous tentacular he's grown from a seedling that was to be the keystone of our business venture. I can't get anywhere near it with Ruth Singer watching me like an augury. Lawley's doing, no doubt. But no one would suspect a student. How would you feel about committing some grand plant larceny?
You said Mr. Lawley was your ex-business partner. What were you working on?
I had an idea to train venomous tentacular. Create guard plants, if you will, that attacked when ordered. We hit a snag when one ate Lawley's neasel. After that, he cut me out of the business, the short-sighted fiend.
Why do you need Mr. Lawley's venomous tentacular in particular?
Simple. If I have it, then Lawley doesn't. Ergo, I can launch my business, and he must start all over again. I'm killing two snidgets with one stone.
What else is in Mr. Lawley's cellar?
All of Lawley's herbology supplies. He has quite the collection. Fill your pockets while you're there. Or to slow him down for a bit. And I can get my business going, minus any competition.
I'll get the venomous tentacular for you.
Marvelous. I know a fellow seeker of justice when I see one. Take as many herbology supplies as you like while you're in his cellar. All I ask is that you bring me the venomous tentacular. Remember, I just need that venomous tentacular.
Seems I need to find Mr. Lawley's cellar. This must be it. This must be the cellar. Now to find that venomous tentacular. Better not let Mr. Lawley see me.
What could... Stop! Stop, bandit!
Let me
Better not let Mr. Lawley see me. Revelio. That venomous tentacular.
Revelio.
Now that I have the venomous tentacular, I should return to Mr. Barnes.
Incendio.
Any luck retrieving a certain friend?
Hello, Mr. Barnes. I have that venomous tentacular.
Wish I could see Lawley's face when he realizes his prized possession is gone. We'll see who's volatile now. Well done. I'll take it off your hands now.
It wasn't as easy to come by as I had expected. I'd like to be paid for my troubles.
Only fair, I suppose. I can respect your business acumen. Here's a little something for your next trip to Zonko's. Thank you again for your help. I suspect you have a bright future.
Glad you came.
Hello, Serona. I received your owl. How are you?
Hello, my friend. Did you ever find Lord Gog?
I did, thank you. We had a good conversation. He sends you his best.
Glad to hear it. I shan't ask for details of your little chat, and I'll refrain from telling you to be careful yet again. But I hope you will be, whatever your plans.
Of course. Your owl mentioned you're needing my help with something?
I do. I thought you might be just the person to do a favour for my friend Dorothy Sprottle in Upper Hogsfield.
I've actually met Mrs. Sprottle. I recently spoke with her about her friend Claire Beaumont.
She's lovely. Her late husband Aidan was a friend of my father's. In fact, I'd stay with Dot and Aidan the summers I waited tables here as a student. I've seen her a few times since Aidan passed, but the pub's been so busy lately, I've not been as attentive as I'd have liked. I wonder if you might pop in and see her. She may need some help collecting ingredients for her supply of Wiganweld potion. And you could retrieve something of mine in the process. A box, full of old letters and such.
I'll try to go and see her when I can.
It would mean the world to me, and to Dorothy. Aidan was bringing the box of letters to me when he was taken ill. Doc can tell you where he might have dropped it. You'll find the hamlet just north of Hogsmeade. Please do give Doc my love.
Not sure how I'd fare in a little place like this.
Again for delivering those.
Lumos. Confringo.
Yes.
incendiary. Revelio. Incendio. Huh? You own them. You're the one. I've seen you duel.
You can do.
I'm not done with you.
Nobody will believe I defeated an Ashwinder by myself.
How nice of you to stop by.
Ranrock has fooled you all to your demise.
I see you. No more happy days for you. That was a mistake. Let's play, shall we?
Avada Kedavra! skin is over with. Rather unwise coming back in.
Learn the error of your ways.
Castle must have been quite stately in its time. Wonder if I'm safe to explore in there.
Revelio. There you are. Now, we need to show the beast you rescued their new home. But, not enough room to let them out here. Imagine all those beasts running amok. That wouldn't do at all. Perhaps if you focus on what your beasts need, the room will provide. What exactly did you think of? Heavens! You've done it!
But what is it?
Deke isn't sure. Only one way to find out. Meet you inside when you're ready. Look at this! It's amazing! Where are we, Deke? It seems to be a place for your beasts to live, a vivarium of some sort. Oh, your beasts will be quite comfortable here. They'll live healthy, safe lives. Perhaps you want to release them, let them see their new home. Deke thinks the vivarium will be a fitting new home for your beasts.
Indeed. I only hope we'll have enough space for all of them.
Deke hopes so too. But if you do run out of room, Madam Peck at Brood and Peck in Hogsmeade will help to find safe homes for them.
Any beasts that the room can't hold?
Yes, she's well known for helping to care for beasts in need, and she'll give you a fair price for them. Speaking of care, beasts that are well-fed and groomed will provide you with valuable magical materials, such as puffskein hair, for example. If you gather some magical materials from your beasts, Deke can show you how to use them.
Very well. I shall let you know when I have some.
Wonderful.
I've collected some magical materials, Deke.
Now Deke can show you how to use them. First, you'll need to use this spellcraft to conjure an enchanted loom.
An enchanted loom?
Exactly. It will allow you to use your magical materials to weave magic into the very threads of your clothing, making your clothing more useful in a variety of ways. Why don't you try it? Deke thinks you'll be impressed with what the loom can do.
I'll go and experiment with the loom now.